Hey everybody, welcome back to another Photoshop CS6 tutorial. Today we're going to learn how to create a type mask. What a type mask is one of the text tools, and when you type it out, it actually makes like pretty much like a selection or a mask. And when you do this, you're able to pretty much have a bunch of different kind of creative opportunities to take what is behind the layer and make it into new text or picture on the text or different kind of color and everything like that. So what we're gonna do is go ahead and create a couple layers and then use our text mask tool. So let's insert an image. Let's just open up an image real quick. And let me go to my images. Oh, that's not the images I want. Let's go to, where's the new Boston? There it is. And then the assets. All right. And I'll just pick basically anything that I can find that might look halfway decent. This one looks cool. All right, now we've got this. I'm gonna make that into a layer, and then I'm just gonna make a new layer, and I'm gonna fill that layer with some white. All right, and now I'm gonna put it underneath this layer. Now I'm gonna use my text tool here, and let's just use some cool looking text. And I'll make it about right here, and I have my text mask tool. I'm using the horizontal one. And I'm gonna start typing. Now you see that everything starts turning red. I wanted to make sure that actually this layer is selected, the top layer, and when I do this. And let's go type in something with a higher font here, way bigger. All right, I'm gonna have to make this way bigger because this picture is a lot bigger than the one things I was using before. How's that? Here we go. All right, there we go. I've got my mask there. Now if I click off, now I've got this mask going on. I can click and drag this off, and look, it takes out the text there. And now I've got some text that I have taken out because it was pretty much like a selection. I'll go back, and if I switch these, let's go back to our layer order, and let's put this on top, and we can go ahead and type now. All right, there we go. And go ahead and move this out. I had it on the wrong layer. That's good. All right, now let's see if it does it. Yeah, there we go. Now I'm picking from what was underneath the text, which is pretty cool looking in my opinion. So it acted as a mask and removed the what was on the foreground from the background. So that's pretty cool in my opinion. If you hit Control D, it'll deselect, and now you don't have a selection anymore. So you don't have to worry about that. So there you have it. That's the mask type tool. We've got a horizontal and a vertical. So if I actually wanted to go vertical, I could if I wanted to. And there we go. Oh, my bad. I could move these if I wanted to by using my selection tools. Here we go. My bad. Let me get right in there. There we go. And now, same thing happens. So, I obviously didn't make this in the right way because it's coming off, but you guys get the idea. And that's all I wanted to show you about this tutorial. Thanks for watching. Hopefully, you guys learned some new cool tricks, and hopefully, you guys can use them in your next project. Thanks a lot, everybody. Have a good day.